ball from behind by Campbell to Royal. Here they go. Cousins with a snap for goal. A beauty. Number 10 coming up if he takes the mark, but he couldn't. Davies gets the goal.
And he's in muddy wrestle.
Oh, down to McPherson. Great
mark,
has to try to beat two of them. That's the Hawkins.
Hawkins
on the left foot and goal.
Chipping in well, Terry
Walsh to mark. Members side, good kick two, and the mark is taken by Hunter.
Low trajectory kick and a great mark taken by Kennedy.
Kennedy. And Mark Kelly.
McPherson. McLean at right half forward of them. Turner in front, doesn't get a good bounce. Hunter, the Hanbury, one of the youngsters. Long shot with the breeze. That could be their first goal. Atkins, bad hand pass, or should we say a good intercept. Kerrisnova runs the ball.
Side, off, clever mark. Campbell controls it well. Hand passes out wide.
Now run out for it. This is Royal from about 60 metres. Lockyer is dropping back. It may bounce through for a goal at half. Lines, Footscray this time. Oh, brilliantly done. Went back and found it off the ground by McPherson. To Campbell. And then looks the threat of Foster.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the VFL Commission and the boards of the Fitzroy and Footscray football clubs are very pleased to announce today the formation of a new force in VFL football called the Fitzroy Bulldogs.
With these words, so was marked the beginning of a new chapter in the history of Australian rules football. It was on the 3rd of October that what appeared to be the fate of the Footscray Football Club had been decided by an entity beyond the control of those who really controlled the game. Perhaps there was no real enemy, but clearly there was a war to be fought.
It's a bit like if you were extremely ill and someone said you need a heart transplant, you don't really want it, but you accept the heart because while it's not your heart beating in there, you're still alive.
And the first time in many, many years they're going to have a winning chance, I would think. And as far as the Footscray supporters are concerned, we're going to try and have as much influence in the western suburbs as we can.
The VFL told us today that it was the finish.
It's difficult to know how much you feel about something until it's taken away. Suddenly you're deprived of something you always had, something you'd grown up with, something that was a part of you.
Well, I don't think decisions like these are easy at any time. I am extremely emotional.
Anger, confusion and hurt are not easily channeled into rational thought. Only instinct leads you to action, to challenge that which has been taken away from you. And with instinct, emotion takes over. The initial dismay and heartbreak that rocked not only the foundations of the West, but the football masses as a whole, can only be characterised by the result that followed. What you're about to see is a real and emotional documentation of the courage and strength shown by people when something they love is threatened.
I mean, I've never seen your face around the cup. I've been there 9 years.
Hey, I've been there 35 years, my friend, and my family.
Well, hey, you've never seen mine either, but that doesn't mean we're entitled.
There's our social club membership. You got yours? Don't stand that rubbish.
While the league chiefs are elated the two clubs have finally bitten the bullet and merged, it's of little comfort to the people who devote a great part of their lives to a club, only to have it pulled out from under them.
I feel sorry for them, and I worry about them, because it has been their life. And I know, I get letters from them, I visit people, I visit an 85-year-old guy last night who lives every year for the Footscray Football Club. Now, I don't know, I'm worried about them, because some people give up.
Get your stickers here off yours, Oakley!
We've been around for so many years, it just won't be the same. It's not our fault, we tried so hard, we're not the ones to blame. But now's the time to make our stand, say what we must say. Who's got the right to take away the heart of old Footscray? There's E.J. Witten's old grandstand and the Dougie Hawkins wing. It mightn't mean that much to you, but to us it's everything. So stand up now and shout aloud. Don't be pushed around, 'cause no one has the right to take away old Foot's great time. Up inside. So listen now to what we say and open up your doors and turn our memories back in time to 1954 and stand up now and shout aloud. Don't be pushed around. No one has the right to take away old Foot's great time. Foot's great time. Foot's great time.
That perhaps one day this would happen, but you know, the way the execution and the way it's gone so quickly, it's just left a real empty feeling. And well, you know, as I said before, we're just looking forward to sitting down with the people and finding out what our future is.
Oh yeah, I'll find it hard to accept, I suppose, but I've got to go into this meeting now, and I suppose hopefully things will be a little bit clearer by the time I leave.
If the supporters were confused, what then of the players? If anything, they deserved an explanation.
Most of the players have come to grips with the fact that unfortunately the merger was inevitable, and I think the guys that are selected in the final 58 players that will make up the Fitzroy Bulldogs list, they'll give it 100% and they'll certainly get right behind the new club.
Okay, what about the other 67 from Fitzroy and Footscray who aren't going to make the list? How are they feeling at the moment?
Well, there'll be a lot of young guys who will be very disappointed if they don't make that list, and they'll take their options and go into the national draft in November, and other guys, of course, will look for other football clubs. But unfortunately, that's the harsh reality, one of the unfortunate sides of it.
Now, there are two types of contracts. There's the Footscray Football Club and the VFL standardised contract. What about some of the players who don't want to play for the Fitzroy Bulldogs, who might like to go elsewhere or don't know how their contracts are at the moment?
Well, that's an option certainly players do have, and you know, if they don't want to sign another contract and go on the standard players contract, well, that's the option they can take. But you know, I think the players from both clubs will give it their all and certainly get behind it and rally to the cause.
We saw some disappointed players there. Was it heated, the meeting?
No, I mean, the meeting went very well. There was a lot of disappointment on the faces of the players as to what's happened, and generally, you know, as with the supporters, everyone's still in a state of shock, but they accepted it, and I think the players will certainly perform in the 1990s.
Earlier in the day, Footscray accountant Steve Smith left the club armed with its financial history on his way to VFL House for an economic summit. Although a die-hard Bulldog supporter, he admits the club has been in dire straits for years, after a significant drop in membership reflected in gate receipts for this year, totalling only $100,000.
They've probably been let down a lot by the local industry. It's been run on a shoestring for a long period of time. Our expenditure level was kept lower than any other club within the VFL.
With the merger of Fitzroy and Footscray, the VFL is doing sums for a 13-team draw next year. VFL Executive Commissioner Alan Schwab says it works successfully for the reserve grade this year and will mean 24 rounds of matches, all teams playing 22 games with two byes each. There will be no MCG State of Origin clash. Two will be played interstate.
Will the length of the season change?
we've got at least 23 weekends from the start of April until the end of September, and we'd have to find another round, and that could be played in the last week of March.
Diana King, 7 Nightly News.
So let the time keep rolling on. It's on my side. Lonely nights will send me home. High is the tide.
Footscray supporter Irene Chatfield, with the backing of the Save the Dogs Committee, earned the reprieve for her club in the Supreme Court today. The VFL agreed to give supporters time to try to get Footscray out of the red. The league says it will not proceed with any transfer of assets, and there'll be no further action by the VFL on contracts or the distribution of players. Footscray supporters now have until October the 25th to save their club. That date fits in with a timetable for player drafts, and the football fixture for the 1990 season will now not be published until November. It was an elated Irene Chatfield who emerged from court this afternoon.
I think it's absolutely terrific. I feel the best I've felt all week.
Supporters have 3 weeks to raise $1.5 million. They're being asked to attend a meeting at the Western Oval on Sunday morning to pledge their financial backing. That money will be placed in a trust fund. Dennis Gallimberti, former Footscray general manager, says he's been guaranteed funds from business groups, but it's the supporters he's counting on.
We want all football supporters from every club, because if they don't come forward now and convert their sentiment into cash, it'll be a North Melbourne next year, or a Richmond, or a St Kilda.
And late this afternoon, the VFL was remaining firm. A statement issued by VFL Commissioner Ross Oakley said the league will not take any steps to pay any of the Footscray Football Club's debts.
If everyone's out there on Sunday to represent the future of Footscray and of all VFL clubs that are in desperate trouble, we can go a long way.
If we got a pledge from 5,000 supporters, they say that they'd all kick in, say, $100, we think that would go a long way towards eradicating the present debt situation.
Well, I can understand their situation, but I really do think they're flogging a dead horse at this stage.
If anyone can get the VFL to change their mind, that's fine. You know, I'm behind that, but I'm here to tell them that they won't be able to. The Footscray Football Club as such is finished. It's now the Fitzroy Bulldogs.
Every dog will have his day, any dog can win.
Some who had been loyal had given in. Others had become suspicious or condescending. A sense of show us what you've got had arisen. Now was the time to channel the emotion. We were not going to die. People could see that there was hope, but a united front was required. Personal indifferences had to be replaced with a sense of achievement. Jump on or get left behind. What had been had to be replaced with what must be.
Today.
With their deadline of $1.8 million this Wednesday, it looked like the Footscray Football Club was gone 2 weeks ago, but a fortnight after their first rally, the Bulldogs have collected over $1 million, and suddenly, through such hard work, their dream may become a reality.
We're fairly confident we'll be able to meet our debts and produce the requirements of having our income exceed our expenses for next year so that we can be in the competition.
Organisers said they would raise $1.5 million by Wednesday to make the club solvent.
I believe it's time that they looked at the whole question of whether they should be trying to reduce the number of Melbourne clubs. I think this whole effort over the last couple of weeks has been a watershed in the history of the league, and I think they'll now have to rethink their whole strategy.
When the VFL issued its ultimatum that Footscray merge with Fitzroy or die, they could not have imagined the revolution that would erupt. Clearly, the commission underestimated the power of the people, and not just the people of Footscray. More than $1 million has been raised, and Save the Dogs chairman Peter Gordon says almost half the donations have come from outside of Footscray. It was more like a football rally than a council meeting, but the message was crystal clear. According to a management report prepared by accountants Coopers and Lybrand, the Bulldogs have a viable future. Although the VFL will spend 2 days verifying information provided by the Fightback Foundation, it seems their survival campaign has been so successful, Footscray will join the elite clubs in the sponsorship stakes. Ross Oakley conceded he is amazed by the response.
It's fantastic, but it needed this action to be taken to have them realise that it was so desperate.
This morning I had tears when I turned the radio on and they said VFL and Footscray have made the deal and Footscray will stay there. The tears just flowed, you know, you couldn't help it. I was really, really pleased.
There was now a time for thought. The pain, the hurt, the strength, courage and determination had all become a blur. The people had fought for what they believed, not what was viable or profitable, but what was right. What had forced people to act as they did? Beyond the unity of the club, each would have a special reason, an anecdote that endeared them to the club.
Well, to me, Footscray means, as Australia, means to being proud of Australia. That's how I feel about Footscray. I followed it from a little tacker with my dad, and the whole of our family has always been Footscray. And to me, when we were dead, it was terrible. You never know what you got till it's gone.
It was like having your family and your home threatened, I think, when we knew about it with the merger, and we were all very tearful.
What then of the players?
To pull a jumper on that maybe has nothing to do with the Footscray Football Club, I think an emblem's supposed to be on the jumper. That's not really the same as putting number 32 from the Footscray Football Club on.
As a kid, I barracked for the football club and I always wanted to play for Footscray. Last year, I had 3 offers to leave the club, and much better offers than what Footscray offered me, and I was so close to leaving, but the only reason I stayed was loyalty to the club. And when this happens, you sort of wonder really what life is all about. I was coming out of the social club last night, and I ran into a guy who was just walking into the social club, and he just stopped me, and I had to talk to him, and the bloke broke down and cried. This is a grown man, broke down and cried because the club is now, there's no longer here, and he just couldn't believe it.
Not even the key figures remain unaffected by the groundswell of emotion that had swamped all those involved in the tenacious fight back.
I recall the story of the old lady in the decrepit old house in Sunshine who, upon being asked to give some money, got $5 worth of coins. The door knocker then thought she lived in such poverty and said, perhaps you ought to keep the money. And she's about 96, this woman. She said, even an old lady of 96 knows the difference between right and wrong. And yeah, there were many moving experiences like that. I think it was very much a question of the Western Suburbs coming of age in that struggle and getting a lot more self-respect.
So, Footscray was now viable in the eyes of all concerned. Yet there could be no dictating as to how such strength could be maintained. A culmination of business and mass support would complement the refurbished club. The establishment of a task force enabled a support base to continue, drawing directly from spectators and football fans alike.
With whatever funds we get in, we're trying to use those funds to help Footscray. Perhaps the most important role is that people feel they're involved in Footscray. And at our meetings, we have sometimes up to about 100 people. Originally, the task force was to be just for 1 year. But like Footscray, it's getting stronger and stronger. So the task force, like Footscray, is going ahead in the 90s.
One of the things that the club's doing, which we believe is terribly important, is it's almost returning the club back to the community. A lot of league clubs these days rely terribly heavily on on major sponsorships. I guess Carlton would be a case in point, but what the club's trying to do is to get tremendous involvement, or at least a much greater level of involvement from the community. They've got a lot of people living in the area, and I think this will work, and I think that's terribly important also, because it will it not only provides financial support through the large community grouping, but it also gives tremendous club support, player support and recruiting opportunities.
It really relies on the supporters learning the lessons of 1989, though, and realising that if they want to have a viable club in the AFL for the 1990s, they've got to work. They've got to work hard for the club in whatever capacity they can. If they're senior within a company, it means that their company's got to get behind Footscray. And in terms of the ordinary member, the person who stands in the outer, they've got to look at the various fundraising things they can get involved in, the various fundraising which, if they're not involved in it in an organisational sense, they can contribute to. Because what we showed in October 1989 is if we do get behind those sort of things, there's not much we can't achieve.
If you're ever tempted to brush aside the events of October 1989, remember the shock you felt. Remember the awful reality of supporters' no man's land. And remember the terrible message given to Footscray by the VFL, as Ted Whitten knew only too well.
There was no other option but to merge. Otherwise, there would be no Footscray Football Club ever again. It was liquidation, the finish.
Determination and the strength of a major corporate sponsor in ICI had consolidated the structure built on tears, heartbreak, courage and determination.
Peter Gordon and his Save the Bulldogs committee, I mean, it's been a fantastic effort, and I'm sure not only myself but all the Footscray players will be absolutely wrapped out of the world.
Well, all I can say is well done. You've really come out of the woodwork, and we've got to congratulate you for what you've been able to achieve in the last 3 weeks, and good luck in the season to come.
I think any player that plays football, even today, I still think there's a little bit of the jumper inside of them. What has happened now with the rebirth of the new club, that identity of the Footscray Football Club is just so clearly defined now.
For the loyal thousands who cheered, supported and battled, it is unquestionably known that every dog has its day.
I get upset. I can't. I'm sorry.
That's all right.
I thought we were going to lose our club.
We all thought that. Well, we've beat them, don't worry.
Yeah.